Platinum 101. In this video, we will be analyzing the market for gold and crude oil from 28 till 29 July. So let's begin. We are on a 1 day chart for the gold, and as you can see, I have drawn this resistance zone, and we were expecting a sale off from some around here towards down. However, this isn't the scenario. Rather, we see an upwards movement which was very aggressive. We have seen that the market has closed above this resistance. Now we have seen that the market has retouched this resistance zone, turning into a support zone. And moreover, we can also see a divergence, which is a regular bearish divergence, as the market is making a higher high move from here till here. However, the indicator is continuously or is making a double top or a lower high move. Thus, this suggests that we can expect a sale off in the market for the gold. And me being bearish for the gold for a shorter time period is the fact that we have seen a huge bullish momentum, and rather, due to this bullish momentum, we can expect short term selling in the market, retesting this support, and then we can see that the market for the gold could advance higher highs. Moreover, on the Monday and Tuesday, we usually see bearish moves. However, this isn't the case. Rather, we see a bullish move. Thus, now I am expecting that the market for the gold on Wednesday, Thursday and Friday can show some bearish momentum signals, and we can expect that the market would be trading in a range from some around here till some around here. And let me draw one more resistance, that would be some around 1917. Let me change its color to pink. This resistance line, which is drawn in pink, this was the resistance tested by the market in 2011. However, here we can see that the market for the gold currently has nicely breakthrough or closed above this resistance. This suggests that the potential in the market bullish momentum is high, and we can further expect higher high moves in the market for the gold. Thus, my prediction for the gold is that for a shorter time period, only for short term correction after this huge bullish run up, we can expect a short term correction, which could be in shape of bullish pennant, and that could be somewhere around here. Now let me remove my drawing so it's more clear to understand. Thus, we can expect a short-term correction. However, we have seen this nicely formed bearish candle, and which suggests that the strength of this bullish momentum or this bullish momentum from some around here till here isn't or is being weak, as this candle has a huge range, some around 1980 till some around 1905, which suggests that in a single day tenure we have experienced a 800 pip momentum in the gold. Moreover, we have seen an 80 points movement in the gold, which is a huge momentum or the movement in which we usually do not see in the market for the gold, as from some around here we haven't seen such a huge momentum or the movement in the market in a single day. Some around here we have seen a huge moment some around here, however we haven't seen around here. Thus, we would be not taking any positions for the gold or any sale position for the gold, would be somewhere out here. Thus, I am expecting that the market for the gold could potentially retest this resistance zone or this support zone. Thus, I would be looking to go long some around here. Some around 1900 with a take profit of this recent highs, with a stop loss some around 1856. This trade will give an index reward of approx 1:1.56. Do remember, we would not be taking sale position on the gold at any extent or at any circumstances. Now, me being bullish for the gold and the fundamentals behind that is that the coming up Fed meeting, which is dated on July 28-29, where the officials are expected to keep the interest rate near zero and debate on possible shift in the strategy. Moreover, Fed's path towards will be closely watched from December 2008 to June 2011, as Fed have bought some around 2.3 trillions of debt. Moreover, on the top of historical low rates, central bank and the government have passed trillions in stimulus packages to curb the economic toll of the pandemic. And if that the country's investors will continue to buy into gold, as said by Nitesh Shah. Moreover, some investors out there are little uneasy or uncertain about what this means for the long-term future. Moreover, the US-China tensions are being rising and there is no clear conclusion to be drawn. Moreover, the COVID-19 pandemic is spreading rapidly and we haven't found any vaccine for it till now. Thus, I would be again repeating, going on a smaller time frame on a 4-hourly chart. Here we can see that the market for the gold has opened and we have seen a bullish rally some around 1817. We have told our team 101 to go long some around here with our take profit of 1910. Then again some around here, we have told our team 101 to go long some around here. Some around here 1910, we have again given signal to close our all trades. Moreover, we can also draw in support trend line for the market. Let me draw that. Some around here. Let me remove my drawing so it's more clear. Here we can see that the market has been making an engulfing pattern, and if we see that this candle closed below this support trend line, thus this will trigger a bearish momentum in the market and we can see a retracement after this support or the support trend line, as the market has taken the support some around here. Moreover, we can also draw up the Fib retracement tool. Let me draw that also. That would be some around here. First, let me remove all of my drawing so it's more clear. Zooming in, here we can see that the market has retraced from some around this golden ratio, which is 61.8, and can see a retracement upwards. However, the candle hasn't closed till now. Then again, what we are expecting. Let me draw my support trend line. It will be somewhere around here. This would be the inner support trend line. This would be the out. This is the inner support trend line. This is the outer support trend line. So what we are expecting, that we are expecting in short term bearish momentum after a huge bullish momentum, and this would trigger a long position somewhere around here with our take profit of recent highs. And the fundamentals are explained why we are bullish for the gold, somewhere around here with a stop loss placed somewhere around 1854 with a take profit of recent highs. This trade will give an extra reward of approx 1:2.28. We are currently on an 4-hourly chart for the crude oil, and here we can see our previous trade setup which we have given the prediction in our weekly forecast. Here we have indicated to go long, and we can see that we have covered some around 50% to 60% of our take profit area, and we can now close our longs on the crude oil, as we can see that the market for the crude oil is consolidating and we can potentially see a retest towards this support. So me being bearish for the crude oil is due to the fact, let me show you that from around here. Let me zoom in. We can see that this resistance trend line has been respecting some around here. We have seen in resistance, again we have seen in resistance, and again we can potentially see a resistance after a test towards here. Thus the T101 members who have gone long could take a close their trades with a profit, and we are now expecting a bearish momentum after a test some around here, retest towards this support trend line. Thus they are both trading opportunities for the crude oil. We would be going short some around here with our stop loss some around here with our take profit of some around here. This trade will give an extra reward of approx 1:1.18. Then after a retest towards this support, we would be expecting a bullish momentum upwards. Thus, after taking our profit on a sale position, we will be going for a long position with our stop loss sum around here with our take profit of recent highs, just placed below recent highs. Thus, our entry trigger point would be somewhere around $40.79 with our take profit of $41.81 with our stop loss somewhere around $40.27. If you like my video, do like, share and comment below, and if you are new to the channel, so do consider subscribing as I upload daily forecast on crude oil and gold. Thanks for watching.